So I received a challenge from Bill from Gulfstream Outdoors to create a crosshatch pattern on a fish bait design. Bill makes Fusion 360 tutorials also, so do check out his channel. I want to thank him for this challenge. The crosshatch pattern is limited to only the top half of the body. I'll be presenting two methods for all of you to consider. For the first method, I'm going to build a cutting tool with fins. For the second method, I will attempt to use an emboss. I will leave a link for you to download the starting model to follow along. For the sake of clarity, I've taken a bit of liberty in simplifying the actual model that was sent to me by Bill. To make the demonstration process easier, I will not be fully defining any of the sketches. The actual dimensions are not important. It will be more of a freehand demonstration. Also, I will be doing a reduced pattern. Understanding the workflow is what matters here. The body has been split into three sections. Let's hide the head and the bottom main body. Let's take a look at the first method. Create a sketch on the right plane. I'm going to sketch a rectangle for the top plate of the cutting tool. You should make this plate longer than the body. Let's extrude this symmetrically. Just make sure that it fully covers the body when looking from the top. This top plate will serve the purpose of linking all the fins together so that we do not need to deal with multiple bodies. It also has the benefit of increasing the chance of a successful model regeneration if you change the number of fins. Again, make a sketch on the right plane. And draw a line to represent the first fin. Begin the extrude command. And select the thin extrude option. Select the line as a profile. Set direction as symmetric. Set wall location as center. Adjust the thickness. The thickness here would represent the groove width that we need. Adjust the distance such that it exceeds the extent of the main body. Set operation to join. We want the fin to merge with the base plate, but not the top main body. So let's hide that. We shall go on to use a rectangular pattern to create a series of fins. Begin the rectangular pattern command. Set type to features and select the fin. Set the direction to be along the z-axis. The rectangular pattern would honor the fact that the fin only joins with the plate in the previous extrude and apply that to all the repeated features. At the end of the operation, all the fins would join to the base plate as a single body. We will repeat the same process to create fins that face the other direction. Let's rename this as a cutting tool. bring back the top main body. We are going to use the top main body to trim this tool. Go to Create, Boundary Fill. Select the top main body. Click on the select box for selecting cells and check this box. This will create a copy of the body. Since we need to keep the original, make sure that the Remove Tools option is not checked. Rename the copy. And hide the original. Go to Modify Offset Face. And create an offset for this face of the copied body. The offset distance here would correspond to the groove depth that you need. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the cutting tool as the target body. And select the copy as the tool body. Set the operation to cut. We do not need the copy after this, so do not check on the Keep Tools option. If we bring back the top main body, we can see that the cutting tool overlaps with it. Begin the Combine command again. This time around, select the top main body as a target and select the cutting tool as a tool body. With this, we have created the grooves. I will leave it up to you to try this out with increased pattern density. The limitation of this method is that it does not really create a crosshatch pattern on the top. You can try to create fins from a top-down view. But you will still be faced with the same issues from the side. Depending on the shape of the main body, the degree of this problem may vary. For the next method, we are going to attempt to use the Emboss command. The problem with the Emboss command is that it can only work on surfaces with 1 degree of curvature. If you look at the main body, it has curvature looking from the front and also curvature looking from the right. So we will not be able to directly apply an emboss here. We will need to create a surrogate body on which we can apply the emboss. This surrogate body will come in the form of a cone, which has only 1 degree of curvature. Hide the head and the bottom main body. Create a sketch circle on this face. This circle should be slightly smaller than the face. Let's perform an extrude with a taper angle. Adjust the distance and taper angle. You want to make sure that the top half of the cone does not exceed the surface of the top main body. Change the operation to new body. When it comes to embossing, it is usually easier to create a larger pattern than required. However, if we do that on a full conical face, we would often run into problems of self-intersection. To ease the embossing process, we will want to split the cone to create a flat face. We can use the bottom face of the top main body to split the cone. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the cone as a body to split. For a splitting tool, click on the select box and select the bottom face of the top main body. Go to the Bodies folder, right-click on the lower portion of the cone, and remove. Hide the top main body. Let's create an embossed pattern sketch on the top plane. To create that pattern, I'm going to first sketch a diamond. Sketch a right angle triangle. Change these two lines into construction lines. Mirror this line. Perform another mirror for these two lines. Draw a line from the center to the midpoint of this line. I'm going to create the pattern in two stages. For the first rectangular pattern, I'm going to pattern the diamond using this line as a direction. Change the distance type to spacing and quantity to 2. Adjust the spacing to have the gap that you need. For the second pattern, we will pattern both diamonds. For directions, we will just use the default X and Y directions. Change distance type to spacing. Change direction type to symmetric for both directions. Adjust the quantity and spacing such that the pattern completely covers the cone when looking from the top. Go to Create, Emboss. Box select all the profiles. For faces, select the conical face. Adjust the emboss depth such that it exceeds the top main body. Bring back the top main body to check. We need to cut off the excess. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Select the face of the top main body and set an offset distance of 0. This will create a copy of this face. Go to Create. Icon. Select the surface body from the Bodies folder. Adjust the distance such that it fully encompasses all the embossed features. Change the operation to Cut. At this point, the embossed features flushes with the original top main body. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify, Offset Face, and perform a negative offset on the face of the top main body. The offset distance would correspond to the groove depth. Bring back all the bodies. And combine them into one single body.